Joseph Moore sat at an old organ. His fingers stretched over the keys, forming the notes of a chord. He took a deep breath and pressed down. Nothing. He lifted his fingers and tried again. Silence echoed through the church. Father Joseph shook his head. It was no use. The pipes were rusted, the bellows mildewed, and full of holes where rats had been chewing on them. The organ had been wheezing and growing quieter for months, and Father Joseph had been hoping it would hold together until the organ builder arrived to repair it in the spring. But now, on December 23, 1818, the organ had finally given out. St. Nicholas Church would have no music for Christmas. Father Joseph sighed. Maybe a brisk walk would make him feel better. He pulled on his overcoat and stepped out into the night. His white breath puffed out before him. Moonlight sparkled off the snow-crusted trees in the houses in the village of Orbendorf. Father Joseph crunched through the snowy streets to the edge of the little Austrian town and climbed the path leading up the mountain. Father Joseph looked over the Austrian Alps. He looked to the heavens as the stars shone above. Then suddenly, through what could only be described as divine intervention, Father Joseph knew how he was going to bring music to the church. The next morning, Father Joseph set out on another walk. This time he carried a poem he'd been working on for the past couple of years. He knew exactly where he was going, to see his friend Franz Gruber, the organist for St. Nicholas Church, who lived in the next village. Franz Gruber was surprised to see the priest so far from home on Christmas Eve, and even more surprised when Father Joseph handed him the poem. That night, Father Joseph and Franz Gruber stood at the altar of St. Nicholas Church. Father Joseph held his guitar. You could see the members of the congregation giving each other puzzled looks. They had never heard a guitar in church before, and certainly not during midnight mass on Christmas Eve, the holiest night of the year. Father Joseph picked out a few notes on the guitar, and he and Franz Gruber began to sing. Their two voices rang out, joined by the church choir on the chorus. Franz Gruber's melody matched the simplicity and honesty of Father Joseph's words. When the last notes faded into the night, the congregation remained still for a moment. Then they began to clap their hands. Applause filled the church. The villagers of Orbendorf loved the song. Father Joseph's plan to bring music to St. Nicholas's Church had worked. Today, cathedral choirs and carolers from New York to New Zealand sing the simple song that was first played in a mountain church in Austria on Christmas Eve nearly 200 years ago. Please stand and join us in singing the miracle that is Silent Night.
Around yon virgin Jesus.